Okay, it is almost 2:15. Yeah, so good afternoon to all. Am I audible to you?
Yes.
So I hope everyone has received the email from us in that regarding the course evaluation. May I request those are attending this session, can you please give your reply on the chat box regarding the course evaluation?
Yes, sir, we got.
Yeah, just to make sure that everyone has received. Of course, in this session only 23 are there, but let me hear from you if anybody is not received, because I have, based on your emails only, those who are emailed regularly browsing our Moodle website, your emails are there with us. So unless until if you have changed your email, so we have the email addresses here. So if you have changed it, we cannot help you. But please inform to your friends also that course evaluation is given, except Lal Tulanga. So the others, everybody has confirmed their email IDs, and we are just sending your message, I mean emails, to these email IDs. So hopefully everybody might have received this course evaluation well in advance, and there should not be any confusion in the later stage. So of course we are in the halfway of our semester, but since this is very peculiar semester for us, and it's not a very typical one, so this announcement of course evaluation, we have taken almost 6 weeks. After 6 weeks we are announcing it. So let me just brief you, and if you're having any doubts, those are attending decisions, you can clarify with us. So let us first complete that course evaluation doubts clarification, then we'll come to the topics of our regular discussions. So let me open the this same course evaluation announcement is also been posted onto our course page. So if you go to our on the course page, below the announcement section you have Internet Technologies course evaluation. So you can also browse it from this particular location. Right, I am just giving you this particular information. So both myself and sir, we have discussed on these various components, and we have come up to this evaluation procedure. So as we mentioned to you, we will be regularly monitoring your academic progress through our continuous assessments on the components like quizzes, assignments, and programming exercises. So continuous assessment, it is for total for 50 marks. So that 50 marks is divided into two components. One you call quizzes and other is assignments. This is regarding MCA students, please. So here quizzes will be, it will be total, quizzes will be more than 10. Most likely it will be around 12 to 14 quizzes will be there. So that's what we plan it. Now to take the best out of this, quizzes, we just formulated like this: average of best 10 quizzes. So we'll collect the best 10 marks that you obtained in the quizzes, and from that we take the average of that. Similarly for assignments too, we account your assignments performance will be accounted for average of best 10 assignments. For the end semester examination, that is again it will be counted for 50 marks. And that 50 marks is divided into two major components. One is a mini project. So that mini project will be announced by Monday. Once we, myself and sir, we finalize it, we will announce it on Monday. So we'll give time for you. So the problem will be announced to be submitted by the end of the semester. That is before the last instruction day. So this, this is a major assignment kind of activity. So major assignment, or you can call it as a mini project. So that constitutes to around 30 marks out of 50. And we'll give the instructions, what needs to be followed and what needs to be very much emphasized, what needs to be taken care by you in solving this particular problem statement and coming up with a case study kind of project, mini project here. So all that instructions will be given on this particular. Of course, it will be posted on the course page as well as it will be sent to your emails. And the remaining 20 marks out of 50, there will be an open book test. So we'll give this list of open books. Most likely, the books which we are already mentioning in the reference part of our slides and our materials. So our slides and materials contains your reference materials for you. So in that, in this open book test also, most likely the same 99%, most likely will be, you can refer to those books for finding out the solution for the questions which are going to be given on a particular day. So that particular day will be most likely after the last instruction day. So there will be a schedule will be given to us. So during that schedule, on one particular day, your questions will be given. Questions, it can be a set of questions. So that question paper will be made online, and your submissions also has to be online. So that duration of the test will be given for at around 6 to 8 hours. So you can submit it within that 8 hours once the question paper is made available to you. So we'll give ample time here to solve or to find out the answers and to write. Basically, it is an open book test. Of course, your conceptual knowledge, your, of course, the practical aspects and everything will be tested on this particular set of questions. So this is respect to the MCS students. And coming to integrated MTech students, of course, the components remains the same, except this instead of assignments, we call it as programming exercises. So basically, you also need to submit on time. Of course, we are means we mostly most of the requests are coming from the students to extend the deadlines for assignments and quizzes. Of course, we have been very much liberal and as well as we are taking into your request very easy. It's not easily, of course. We can say that we are very much concerned for your request. So we are postponing them to other set of possible dates. But from now onwards. From now onwards, please make sure that you are going to follow the regular deadlines. So the same components, quizzes 25 marks, average of best 10 quizzes, program exercises, average of best 10 program exercises. Programming exercise means one set of exercise. Here that set of exercise contains multiple tasks. So that is what here in the assignments also, there is a multiple task or multiple problems as a one set of exercise. Coming to the practical part of integrated MTech students. So the practical part here, the integrated MTech students, you have 100 marks as a whole. And here, these 100 marks are given, distributed among these two tasks. So task one, you can call it as a task or an activity. So here you are going to design and develop an application for web page crawling. What is meant by crawling? That's what I'll try to explain to you now. So you are going to go into different websites and collect information which are available from that websites. So that is basically a concept called as crawling from one from your web location, from your clients, you are going to crawl. Crawl means you are going to pass on or you are going to go forward to other websites, collect the information and get it into your website or into your database. So here, that is what we call it as web page crawling. And the other task, we are giving an open choice for you. So that choice, you have to first, you have to yourself have to disclose or you have to mention what is the problem that you are going to likely to solve. So that same problem is not going to be solved by, same problem should not be solved by more than one student. In simple terms, it should not be copied. In to make a restriction or constraint in that regard. So what we expect is for the task one and of task two, for task one, the web page crawling, the subset means basically what exactly you are going to crawl or what exactly you are going to retrieve the information from different sources. So that you need to mention it. So think about these two problems. We have given sufficient time for you. So by 25th October means another coming 9 days, you can come out with the problem exactly what is that you are going to crawl or what is that you are going to retrieve or what is that you are going to collect the information from various websites or web resources. That you need to inform in the announcement section so that the other students can look for some other problems under the same problem sphere, means under the same problem domain. Now, similarly, for the task two also, we are given up to 30th, 14 days time is given to you, problem of your choice. So here for the task two, you can use any set of programming tools. We are not confining to this, but for the task one, what are the tools that we have covered so far? So we are using that tools only, you have to come out with a solution. Of course, on the internet, you will using Python, this particular web page crawling can be done, but we are not discussed Python in this. So you have to put efforts in trying to solve that problem using either the LAMP or VAMP or XAMPP stacks, or you can go with Node.js and MongoDB along with the JavaScript and Ajax. So you have to put efforts, every one of you have to put efforts for your own web page crawling statements. So these are the two different tasks that constitutes your 100 marks. So you can come out with your own problem statements. So you are given time for one is to 25th October for the task one, and the task two, you can put it by 30th of October. These are only problem statements, but you can complete that problem. See, once you've given 30th October, you have 1 month time to complete your own problem for the task two. And once you are given for the task one, it is 25th, you have 3 weeks of time to almost complete your the task one. So if you successfully complete both the tasks, so what are the tasks should be there? Again, we will specify it more clearly what we are looking into this task. What are the features that you need to take care? So again, because that features constitutes the marks correlated to the marks. So that we will display to you by Monday. So just that those clear instructions, the means in-depth instructions, what exactly you are going to look into that solution, that we will try to inform you by Monday for this task one and task two, as well as for the mini project. So this will put it by these three things, more clear instructions on these tasks will be announced on this course page, as well as it will be sent to your webmails. Now, yeah, any doubt here, please, so far? Almost 28 students are now, 27 students are there. MCS students are also there, and integrated MTech are also attending the session now. Any doubts regarding the course evaluation, please?
If you have any doubts, like this is the time to come out with. Okay, so once we finalize, we are more or less finalizing the course structure, course evaluation structure, more or less. Okay.
Okay, anyway, you may not come out with this immediately. Of course, you will be discussing among yourself and with your, means among your peers, and of course, you may discuss with other people also. So you come out with your own doubts, at least we will not freeze it until Monday. So we are giving your time. If you have any doubts, you can clarify with us during these 3 days, because we cannot keep it open like that. So once you have freezed it, you are going to stick to that deadlines and the activities and those tasks. So if at all any considerations to be done, we need to consider now only, and we need to freeze it, because everybody should be clear with what are all the components that gets assessed and what is that they are going to finally get the outcome. But since most of us are new with these topics, we hope you give a bit more time so that we can do these more efficiently. Very good. See, if you look to our academic calendar, so the academic calendar says that we have a last instruction day is up to December 2nd week. So December 2nd week, we have the time. And now this is this mini project is given, need to be submitted by the end of this semester. End of the semester means December 2nd week. Now we are in the October 16th. November 16th and December 16th almost. So 2 months time is given for you for this solving this mini project, 2 months time. Of course, 2 months time is a very long time which is given actually. In fact, I think 8 weeks almost. If not 8 weeks, at least 7 weeks time is given. for this mini project. Similarly, for this web page crawling, we are asking you to submit by 15th November. See, 15th November, at least 1 month before this particular end of our semester almost. And 15th November is almost 1 month from now on, 4 weeks time. And 30th November, again, it is 6 weeks time. See, we have announced these questions as a components. Of course, they are new topics to you. I agree. And these are all this exercise. Okay, let me just show you one example for this design and developing web, an application for web page crawling. I have put that sample copy also here. Okay. Let us now try to understand this simple one, just a one page program of logic of PHP MySQL. What are the features I have discussed so far in our video sessions and in your previous session? I will tell you here. You know how to store data in a database, PHP MySQL. These are the simple statements which I have already given a demo. Two video sessions demo I have given to you. Using PHP and MySQL. These are the statements. Once you collect the data from a particular website, you are going to store it into your database. These are the simple steps. These are the simple steps in the sense, simple instructions here. Storing data in the database. This is a common PHP MySQL. If you just complete these instructions, this instructions exercise, already we ask you to do it in the regular exercise, please. This is like storing your data in the database. Now, if you come to, so like they see here, of course, this is a PHP syntax. Now, this is a variable, that's all. This is $main URL. So you are looking for Microsoft.com company website. This is a website which you are looking now. What is that you are going to get from this website? You are going to get some contents from this website. That's what you are, and that contents are been stored in your local variable str. So obviously this str, the contents of that website, the length is greater than zero. So what is that you're looking for? You are trying to collect the title. So where you can get the title of that website? See, if you go to your www.microsoft.com, you go to this website, you know what is the title is. What is the title of this web page, please? Sir, what does AIML? I'm coming, please. Just hold on. I'm just explaining one by one here about the time schedule here. So here you are getting the title, and this is a regular expression. This regular expression, how do you write for a regular expression to get the title from this is what your matching string is. So when you are writing the email validation, for the email validation, you might have used your regular expression. So the same regular expression you are using for this. Similarly, you are getting the web page description. This is the title and this is your web page description. So you are getting the description of the web page and you are getting the title of this web page. And you are just written those two values to be stored in your database. So it means you went to the Microsoft.com and you collected the title of that Microsoft.com web page and you collected the web page description and you stored in your database. This is a simple activity. You are going to another website. That is your, what you call it as crawling. You are just going to that website, collect the information and put it into your database. So what exactly this web page crawling will be useful for is I have given one example here. Suppose you're looking for alumni details of our school. So our school students who have attended our school for various programs, they are now working in different companies, different places, different locations. You can also retrieve their information. How you retrieve the information? Yes, if suppose they say School of Computer and Information Sciences, this is one important keyword here. Or University of Hyderabad. These are another important keywords. Or these keywords, sometimes you may find it in your Facebook Sometimes you may find it in your charts. Sometimes you may get it in another institutional or academic or other company websites. So you can just crawl that in, get that information and store it in your database so that you can build our own alumni database in to some extent. So this is one example, another example. Collect information from different web pages. It is not a very big deal. Only thing is you need to write a program. You can follow PHP MySQL. You can follow, this is the example, a sample web page crawling for PHP MySQL. Or you can follow Node.js, MongoDB, a combination of that one. It is up to you. That's what we have given that instruction here clearly. And we are giving time at least almost more than 1 month. If you are completed by this time, PHP MySQL should be completed by this time, most likely. Because now already if you look to our schedule, see, we already surpassed these sessions. The LAMP PHP is already over, cookies is over. JDBC, Node.js, MongoDB is going to be over this week. Then we went to the servlets. Now we are going to the other units. So that is an activity, a case study based on the previous topics. That's what our actually the objective of our giving the task is. So far we have completed the topic. So you need to complete that task. A little bit a mini project or a kind of task programming exercise. This is especially for integrated MTech students. Programming, you need to be very strong enough in the sense that your logic, your programming skills, your development, web development skills should be very much strong enough. So that is what we look into that aspect base. So reasonably, we are given time. That's what, of course, our what I guess is basically, of course, we have given the deadlines up to November 15th. Most likely, before start of the work itself, you are asking for extra time.
And Nagendra.
Yes, sir.
Just 1 second, okay? Let these deadlines be very fixed ones, okay? So there can't be any extensions here. The reason is simple. The point is, we have to finish all the things by that December. So December 2nd week. So that means like the idea is, this integrated practical one should finish 15 by November 15th. Then the lab two should finish by the end of month. Then the mini project should finish by December 15th. Until and unless like we follow this deadline strictly, the students can't reach. Or else like all the tasks they have to do in sequence, in parallel, more or less. That will be a problem for the students themselves. So let's ensure like they stick to these deadlines very strictly.
Integrated MTech students, don't think the more works are given to you. The main objective here is you need to be regularly doing. Every day you have to do. That's the point here, actually. It's not that once in a week you do it. It's very unfortunate. That's what even I feel it. Most of the time, you just look into these programming exercises simply that all whenever the deadline is approaching, then you start doing those things. It is not like that place. So every day you need to see programming exercise. If you look to our by this time, usually completed HTML, CSS, JavaScript, you might have completed. So from now onwards, your programming exercises will be very simple, at least 4 or 5 exercises only in a week. So at least you need to do every day at least 2 or 3 problems. Every day. That is not just just once in a week also. Not once in a week in the sense that only one day you allocate your time for doing those, solving those exercises. No. So it is a continuous process every day, please. So the coming 2 months are very crucial for you. Every day you have to do some, at least 3-4 exercises. And those 3-4 exercises are programming exercises only. We are not asking you to do any physical activity or just data entry activity. No, we are not asking you to do some simple, trivial, mundane jobs for you to do some collection of data and do that. It's a programming exercise. So, yeah, let us try. You try as you as much as you can. You try your best, and there is some cushion. There is some gap is there for us. If at all in the worst case we need some more time, yes, we are reasonably put those deadlines for you. Almost 6 to 8 weeks we have given time for you. Before 8 weeks only we are giving you the schedule for you.
Sir, like I would like to tell you one thing. Sir, can you hear me?
Hello?
Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah. Please go ahead.
The problem is like, since we are doing this for the first time, like it's not the problem of time, but we really want to do them efficiently. Like, so like the first assignment, I'm still doing it. So I kind of like, I found few new things like doing some glowing text with CSS, etc. I thought that, so like if you give, like you told that by Monday we'll get what all features we need to include in the project. So like since the time is fixed, so it would be good if you kind of keep less features, but they are efficient. Like I found that glowing text somewhere, so I tried to include
in my project. Yeah, Subraman, you're right in what is required for you. See, I will tell you, user interfaces like web user interface or web design or some web applications and all, there is never ending actually. In fact, the more you can keep on add your own features, it is all up to the user's intuitiveness, in the sense that your imaginations comes into picture. So always that's what we do, what is required for those. We will confine to that, because that must be uniformly graded among all the students. Yes, regarding sir. The assignment one and assignment two, you can keep on improving. There is never ending. That is, all the graphics you can put. Even if you want to put audio, you want to put video. Even if you want to go to 3D visualizations, also you can go for those interfaces. So what I'm telling is, there's any activity, especially our user interface design and development. It all depends on our imagination. The developer imaginations comes into picture. So I'm telling you, don't worry about going for keeping more and more advanced features. Of course, for learning, it will be easy for you. So I'm telling you clearly, this task one, task two of your integrated MSX students about the lab and the mini project. So I am in that process only. That's what I want to put it along with this, but somehow I could not complete those things now. So I just I will discuss with sir, and again we will finalize it by Monday. So during the Mondays, our interactive session, by that time it will be put those what exactly features for each and every task what we are looking for, so that you will confine your work also to that much extent only, and you can able to complete on time. So we will not keep open. Oh, it is not an open-ended problem for those task one, task two, and task the mini project task. So that will give it. So is it clear, Subramanian?
Yes, sir.
Riya Kashyap, sir, we have to decide on our own for mini project. No. The mini project, you are in MC area, right? So here, look carefully here. The one we are going to announce that statement for you. So here, this mini project that's made to be submitted by the end of the semester, that is before the last instruction day, we will not keep an open-ended problem for you here. We will announce you that along with the instructions, what exactly needs to be done. So this will be, you have 8 weeks time for the MCS students. 2 months before only we are telling this, you can submit before the last instruction day, any day before. It can be the last day also. So we are giving ample time for you to solve it. So this mini project and task one of integrated MTech, task two of integrated MTech students, this will announce the instructions, means the set guidelines, you can call it as a procedure, or what is the inputs, what are the outputs, what are the interface designs and all. That statements will be given to you, that instructions will be provided to you clearly by Monday. But why we have kept it here is, at least you will have no idea what is going to be there. So we'll let us not completely jump in internally all the details and make you to confuse you. At least you have now a big picture about the course evaluation, what are all the things that we are looking for basically. The next question is, okay, so Nitin Sai, what does you yes, very important question, Nitin Sai. What I told you in the beginning of our semester only, see, nowadays if you look to my JavaScript class also, I clearly mentioned we are using JavaScripts for implementing AI and ML libraries. means AI means artificial intelligence. ML means machine learning. So now the latest technologies, what is exactly happening on the web applications is that how we can put our AI and ML. Now your question, immediate question is, sir, we have not studied AI and ML. How do we do it now? Is it right, Nitin? What is that you are expecting now? No, sir. So what is your, exactly your doubt is? I will tell you, see this particular task, what does AI ML library means? See, into this task two, what we expect here is, see, the applications, you should choose something related to the e-commerce or search engine optimization. SEO stands for search engine optimizations. CMS stands for content management system. LMS stands for learning management systems, like what you are seeing the Moodle now. Moodle is one of the your LMS only. So like this, here SEO, search engine optimization, is what your Google search is doing now. Of course, we don't want to go for very, very big projects in all. So when I'm discussing unit number 5, I'll come up to Google search engine carefully. So that's why this is given up to 30th November. But it is all up to you. In e-commerce, what does e-commerce do? Anybody, e-commerce websites, what does they do? For such applications, we need data. Yes, I'll tell you. Nitin, because the point has come rightly, let me just elaborate to you and you will get your ideas clearly. So can anybody tell me what does an e-commerce website do? What are all the features or what are the activities an e-commerce website does? Like Amazon, sell the things, very good. So in that selling the things, if suppose a user browses some of those items like Amazon, most likely what the user, based on his selection of those such, some of the items, some of the products, some likely products are also going to be displayed to you. In very simple terms, some suggestions, product recommendation. Yes, we call it as recommender systems. Recommendation systems, or you can call it as recommender systems, RS. There is a big, these are of course a little bit bigger tasks, recommender systems and all, but those bigger tasks were there as called as bigger tasks some years back. But nowadays they are just likely a simple task to be done by, should be done by a web developer. So there are built-in functions are there on your JavaScripts. So there are libraries are there, machine learning and AI libraries, which can be applied on your JavaScripts for implementing your regression techniques or classification techniques or prediction. So usually in our AI and ML, you have something called as predict, what you call predict. Suppose I say y is equal to mx plus c. What does y is equal to mx plus c, this line of mathematical formula, which you are hearing from your childhood, what is y is equal to mx plus c equation is giving us information? Anybody? Especially these questions are related to integrated MTech, not for MCA students, of course. Saurabh, you are MCA, I understand it is a straight line, y is equal to mx plus c, very good. Any other? Sir, can we have groups for the lab projects? No, these are all individual assignments, individual tasks, please. Individual person has to do. Tarun is telling a line with slope m. Okay. What are all the things you can have it? Y is equal to mx plus c, what does it indicate, please? Very simple. Hypothesis, it's not hypothesis. So I will tell the equation in summary form. If you are given a value of x and you know the slope and continuous values, yes. Yes, Rastogi, you are right now. Continuous values prediction is the word prediction I'm looking for. So if you know the value of x, then you can know the value of y, provided your slope and your constant values are known. It means y is equal to mx plus c. If you are given a value of x, you can get the value of y. Y, of course, that is your straight line on your graph. You can predict what is will be the value. So this is basically a regression equation. You can have it. So like this, see this equation, this MI, say ML and AI, you are learning it from your childhood. You don't think that you are going to learn under that heading now. So whatever the equation, mathematical equations that you have learned in your childhood days and your college days, it is a part of your AI and ML only. So the simple equations you can make use of, those your y is equal to mx plus c can be made use of in your predicting the what that particular more likely the user is going to select a particular product. So this probability and statistics which you have learned earlier, all those topics, along with the mathematical equations, probabilities, statistics, your regressions, coordinate geometries, whatever you have done in your childhood days and all, you need to refresh yourself now. Of course, you need to rewind your mathematics fundamentals. So do not worry. So you can take a simple example of anything like that. So you can take any e-commerce, means something like a prediction. Or in search engine optimizations, you can put something like search Google search keywords. You're not going to very do a Google search engine algorithm redevelopments, but you can at least put some kind of lookup words using LMS, something like you are going to put some uploading of your files and retrieving the data from the files. Such operation can be there on your LMS. Very simple tasks, you can do it based on all the topics that you have done or which you have done so far. So these kind of ideas, you can discuss with us during our interactions, and we can give you some ideas. So like this in the next Monday or the next week discussions. So think about it in that line. So you will be using those libraries, very simple. Library means a methods only, very simple methods that you can put it in your program and complete your task as quickly as possible. So those are the things. Of course, at a stretch, if you see all those things, you may think that it is a very big, so many things are being given at a time. Let me tell you one thing. If there are not so many things, they are very, of course, you may say that as a teacher, it may looks very trivial for us. No. We have, as a student, I have thought, and sir also has thought, what can be done, what cannot be done. And we feel that for integrated MTech students, your programming skills should be further sharpened with respect to web application development. So that's why we have given more programming exercises as compared to the MCS students. So these two tasks are basically your programming skills only, your logical skills with your programming needs to be done for the latest application development.
Let me also add something here, okay? So for the people, like, if you are feeling like we are giving a lot of tasks all at once, just don't feel like that one, okay? Actually, you also have those two extra credits of practicals, isn't it? So for the two extra credits, okay, 3 plus 2, you need to do a practical exercise almost like once per every week, okay? That's why we are actually trying to give you the assignments. Okay. And along with the assignments, you have to do something bigger task so that, like, you actually understand the complete concept of it. In the assignments, mostly you are fixed to one or two topics. Whereas these mini are like these bigger assignments should actually be able to tell you like how the process continues, complete process works. Okay. So what we have done is like we have given you only two tasks for those two credits. In fact, actually, you see, like, you are getting 2 credits more than MCA people, and all you will be doing is just these 2 tasks extra. Okay. And we have given the tasks which are to be finished after 2 months right away. So that, like, you will be in the process of understanding, you will be adding all the new concepts, whatever you will be learning, it into those particular exercises. Okay. So we are advertising the topics today, but we are not demanding you to finish all the things immediately. Okay. So please understand that one. It's a continuous process. So in 4 weeks, like, you will be submitting something, that is exercise 1. In 8 weeks, you will be submitting the exercise 2. Come on, for your 2 credit points, you have to deal with a task every week. In fact, actually, we are not overloading you. We are giving you very little tasks considering the current COVID-19 situation. Please understand that. Okay? Clear?
Yeah, and please make sure that every day you do little task. At least 3-4 exercises has to be done every day, everyone. It's like our food for the thought. You can say every day 2 to 3 exercises has to be done, programming exercise. You can do regularly those exercises, as well as you can do think about your mini projects. So until unless you don't do every day, yes, this task will never be completed on time. That is what the most
Yes. Yes, Rostogi. Okay. Let me add something for you. Okay. Let me try to tell you something. All of you are asking us for extensions for these sort of quizzes. Okay. We have given very clear deadlines and also like assignments. The problem is, right now, say for example, for assignment 4, I can give you the extension. But think about the situation. You need to have 10 assignments in total. So the if we extend assignment 4, assignment 5th, assignment 6th, assignment 7, 8, we cannot extend them. Because all the assignments should be finished before the last instruction day. Please understand that. In the beginning itself, we had all the free time. So basically, like, try to cope with all the things. Say, for example, none of the quiz deadlines you should be missing. None of the assignments deadlines you should be missing in the beginning. Because at the end, like, we all will be cramped. Say, for example, if we extend assignment 4 by one more week, it will actually intersect with the assignment 5. There is no escape. Because by last instruction day, we have to finish all those 8, 9, 10 assignments. So not much we can do. So in the beginning itself, don't try to delay the things and then like drag it. If there is a valid reason for it, we can actually give an extension. Say, for example, somebody is hospitalized or something like that. But just for the sake of it, don't ask for extensions. I mean, see, the point is we can give you the extension, but the problem is like then your assignment 5 will be intersected. Your assignment 6 will also be delayed. Assignment 7 will also be delayed. Okay? And then like for assignment 10, we can't give any extension. On the last instruction day, all the assignments, all the quizzes, all the tasks, including this mini project should be submitted, finished. Okay?
Sir, so, with your permission, sir.
Yeah, please.
With sir permission and with others also, if at all you are finding that 10 assignments and 10 quizzes are more to you, then at least we can reduce to 8 and 8, something like that. We can come out. So that you can think over it and let us know by Monday. So at least...
And again, let me say something like this. The quizzes are much easier ones. Let's not reduce the number of quizzes, okay? Assignments probably like we will reduce it to something like 8, okay?
So that we can
do that.
The best, again, the best average of best only we are giving you.
Yeah, exactly.
Average of best is more considerable actually. Whatever best you can do it, you do. At least the other assignments also you should do it. Until unless you don't do those assignments, your programming skills not be improved. So that is the point here. So don't worry about the extension. We are always here to. We are extending it further only. There is no. We are not put any hard deadline for these assignments. So Ashwastogi, definitely it will be extended for the assignment for another 1 week.
Sir, excuse me.
Yeah, Subramaniam, yes, please.
Sir, like it's not a problem that we have many assignments, but the problem is that like you people are teaching, I mean, you're putting the videos in the Moodle server. So like one thing that like I felt was that like it's not the number of questions, like the questions are not like your teaching was not up to the mark of those questions. Like for I only did up to HTML, CSS, and I did a bit part of the next JavaScript, like I completed them. So in that, what I found was like the quality of the questions were good, but the teaching, like it was more like we were learning, like we had to do our work to learn them. But like you were not covering the scope of those things, like you were not covering a few things that we had to go find for ourselves and then do them. Like that's what I felt on those, like the quality of your teaching, like the teaching was good, but the quantity and the amount that you are covering were not kind of helping us. Like that's what I felt.
Quantity and
like I mean the quantity meant I meant the scope of those things.
Yeah, can you
I meant quantity means like the scope of those things. Like there are a few things that you missed, so we had to find them again. Like it's good for us to find them, but like there are few things that it becomes tough for us to find since we are new to these topics.
Okay, miss, it is difficult. Are you referring to the books what I mentioned at the end of the slides?
No, sir. I mean like. It's like we already have many subjects, like it would be good if you like kind of cover the everything in the this thing, like I exactly can't tell you, but if you cover everything, like if you at least give us a heading about everything present in something, then it would be good for us to like we can at least search them, like we only things is,
I will tell you how much duration that videos have been there. Can you know what is the video duration that you are seeing?
Yes, sir. Like there are around 40 minutes and the basic ones are from 5 minutes. So
if you go for more information to be delivered by me, it will take more than 1 hour, 1.5 hour for each topic.
Sir, like I meant, it's not like if you at least name them, like for example, in the first map question, like I heard from other people, they could use something called SVG. Like, I don't know about that one. So like,
I'll tell you. See, that's what. See, SVG, nobody asked you to do for SVG because the problem is some students know something. Usually some students always will say that I know this, I know that, because they might have studied earlier or they might have known to that.
I gave an example, like it's not only SVG, like we can, like there are many things that can make our work simpler so that like we can do it.
See, Subramanyam, you are thinking that you can make the thing simpler only when you know about it. Until unless you don't know it, it will take long time. That's, I agree to that. The problem here is, what happens is, we cannot give the complete every topic, every word, every whatever the thing on the video presentation. So we usually give the reference book from where we are referring or where from which book you need to refer further. So
yes,
if you can refer to that book further only, that is enough. If you are going to refer with you with respect to what your friends are doing with different features and different other things, then that is never ending. That is for sure.
Like what I would like to tell is, like, because you already know what questions you are going to ask in the assignment, so like if you can include those things that are related to the assignment, then it will be like beneficial for both of us, so that you already
to be very frank, whatever the questions they are there in the assignment, only those things are there in the video presentation. If you can point to point, if you let me explain to you, if you want I can explain point to point to that one. Whatever question is there in the assignment, whether that point is covered in the video presentation or not, in a complete sense also. But if you are thinking that it is something else is also there, then that we cannot satisfy you. That is going to be never end.
Like, for example, the calendar question, like I saw somewhere in the internet, like they use JavaScript.
That's what I'm telling. Please remember here. I'll tell you in the Google, if you search for a particular solution to a particular whatever the assignment problem you are given, people will give you n number of ways of solving that. The problem is that n number of ways we will not be able to tell you in this.
Like you won't be able to use them, but like for the calendar question, like we generally, like what I could do was, like I could, like I only fix an year and then they'll choose the month.
I'll tell you, Subramanyam, the problem is in the interactive session, only one or two people are asking, sir, what is expected from that question? Like that, people have asked it.
Yes,
rather,
sir, like,
than asking the teacher, if you go into search on the internet, okay, this question is there, the solution is also there on the internet, and in the solution, some tags you might have not what we might have not referred, or what we might have not told you, the solution may contain those things, and those things will think that, okay, we have to learn on your own. So like that, if you keep on searching and keep on exploring, that is going to be never ending for you. And that's what I'm telling you. That's
like,
why that these interactive sessions are meant for that only. You have to yourself clearly ask the teacher what is expected from this. And if you don't, we teacher don't tell, then you have to take it in a, you can search it on your own and you can be a very complex thing.
Unless
you don't ask the teacher here, what is expected from this, what is features, because you are just looking for a Google search and you are looking for solutions which are there available on the Google search, and those solutions will be having very complex solutions. Sometimes you may not know. That's why those things are very new to you. That will create a lot of problem to you. So that's why a teacher is required for you. So up to what level I have to go through, you have to, if you are not clear how to, you can ask the teacher every question, each question one after the other, sir, what is expected in that, what is like that. Sometimes you people are attending these interactive sessions, sometimes you are not attending, and you don't know what is discussed about those questions, and you yourself are thinking you can search it from the internet, and when you search it on the internet, you will find so many other new things which you went on not known this. So that will make a lot of confusion and complex for you.
Yes,
so
sir.
That's why, yeah.
Like it was my mistake. I mean, like we need to ask you to what extent do you need the...
Yes, you can ask. That's what. See, the when you miss the problem here is, that's why. Because some knowledge is there with you. That is making you to search on the internet and look for that solution. And the solution, it is more obvious that you may not know those features at all. So, and that will tell you, and that will make your mind, sir has not told in his video presentation about these tags or about these features. Then how he is expecting us to give solution for this? So these questions normally come. I agree that if you go for that directly onto your search and directly onto your thinking, then if you might have asked the teacher during these interactive sessions, sir, I do not understand this question, but when I searched on the internet, these are the features, and you, these features are not told by you in your video presentation, then how do we go about it? If you can ask the teacher directly in this interactive sessions, this your confusion will be sorted out easily.
Yes, sir. We need to ask you. Fine.
If you don't ask it, and if you start exploring on your own things, definitely that is going to be, see, you are here, this web application development is very vast. It is not just a simple mathematical formula or mathematical logic or mathematical procedure we are explaining to you here. See, these are web applications, so many features, so many things, so many people, they are doing it different ways. So when you start looking into these aspects, obviously you will get confused and you think that these things are should be known to you, and the teacher is not telling in the video presentation. How is the teacher is expecting us to do? So you are going in a wrong direction. That's why these interactive sessions are there. These interactive sessions are to you clarify those doubts. You come up openly, tell or ask what is that you are facing the problem there. If you don't come up and you start thinking or you start discussing, and there's another problem. Some of the students may discuss among themselves. So all those things, whenever you discuss, one student may show some features, other students may show other features. And if you start discussing, oh, these are all the things, but the teacher has not told. That's why when you, yes, it is a good way of discussing among the students to get more information rather than to make your thinking very complex. So all these interactive sessions are meant for that only. See, I can hardly see around 20 to 25 or 30 students are coming here. And sometimes out of this 20, 25, around 10 to 15 are only regular. The remaining 15 are also not regular. So if you can ask the, what are the things to be done and what are the not to be done, then we will clearly tell you. We are here to explain to them only. We are most of the time we are telling in the assignment four questions, that's why what to be done. Even SVG, I myself know SVG we are not explained to you. Because other students are doing SVG, I'm giving an example. You are also thinking that you have to learn for SVG. Then without doing SVG also, you can do, I have told what are the other methods.
Yes.
Yeah, so that's thing, please clarify. You whenever you have such kind of doubts, you must immediately, either you can send a mail or you can send, either you have a discussion. And if suddenly some days comes like this, suddenly you will start, means these things, then all the time will be completely washed out by the time. Okay, sir, comment be done for each thing in the mandatory and assignment three. I mean, I have done only for main things as my concern. Don't worry, at least, see, we look for whether you have known the logic and you have logically able to solve that particular problem. So the main important logics also, if you can explain, that is fine. Sir, so all assignments in the beginning will be counted for theory course. Yes, definitely, that's what I'm telling you from all, Tarun, all assignments, not all. Average of best, I told you, best 10, we said, we can come to best 8. Not all of them will be counted. Okay. Saurabh Kumar Chaudhary. Okay, sir, got it. Yeah. So for today, yeah, we are taking enough, I mean, extra time for you. Any other burning questions for today? By Monday, we'll come out with that instruction wise, what task one, task two for integrated and the mini project for all of them should be there. So that we will be clear in our evaluation. Yeah. Is it possible to declare the number of best assignments? That's what we can come out to, that we will decrease it, but let us see. Monday we will finalize those things. So it is not at freeze, those evaluation, that is open to all. Think about it. You have time for to today, tomorrow, and after tomorrow. So once you have any other burning problems are there, we'll discuss it and we'll sort it out on Monday, and we'll freeze it on Monday. sir, should we submit assignment 3 in IT section or IT lab section? All programming exercises of integrated MTech students should be submitted on your lab sessions. Your programming exercises are your assignments only. You have to submit on your lab practicals only. MCS students, as an assignment, they will submit it on the theory page. Saiteja, is it clear? Saiteja, is it clear, Saiteja? Hello. Yeah. So all programming assignments has to be clear, I mean, has to be submitted clearly on your lab page. And the theory for MCS students, the assignments will be on the theory course page. Yeah, any other burning questions, please? Thank you, sir. And sorry if I meant nothing like that. Subramanya, you know me very well. I know you very well. So nothing like that. Don't take it any harsh. Nothing like that. Everything we are, see, you are in the learning stage. So we all, my intention is to make you to clear, very clear. And you should not get confused and you should not get upset. That's what the problem. So you should be very much clear and really, and frankly, you need to complete your task. Sir, I already submitted in theory course page. Tarun, please submit in your lab exercise has to be submitted in the lab exercise page only. Please don't submit here. You can submit there as well. It is open there. Please submit, because the integrated MTech students, that is a lab page which is separately created for you. So you need to put all your things on this. Yeah.
Yeah, please put it like that one. Actually, we got the instructions like, so for all the lab exercises, like, we have to keep a record of all those things. So it is better that you submit them there. UGC is basically giving guidelines for that one.
Yeah. So if you have any other doubts, you can as well approach us through your emails. Some burning question is there. And please, so these interactive sessions are meant for you to have some clarity. Please always. So don't hesitate to ask us the questions. Either you can post it on the chat box, or you can post it through our emails, or you can directly ask over this. That is what our interactive sessions is. So if you lose this time, then that confusion will always be there. That misconception of what are all the things should we learn, because it is a very vast topic. Very vast, it means so many features are there in the web application development, because that is what internet era is all about. So that's why you should not be lost in that forest. It is like a very forest only. When you are moving in the forest, you need a proper guide. The teacher is the guide for you here. The teacher is meant for you, that only. So you have to follow the guidelines of the teacher. Very positively, you have to follow it. If you are been stuck somewhere, he is the person who is going to solve your problem. So that's why always have belief and be positive, and things will go very easily for you. So you will be wandering with so many other thoughts. All the thoughts will be cleared by your teacher. So please put your questions very frankly, very regularly. Whatever the questions with respect to the subject, you need to be very clear for you always. So that will make your it's a healthy learning environment for you. Any other doubts, please? So please take care of yourself. Yeah. So because this is a COVID situation, in the last, I mean, the last 2-3 days back also, we had a very uncertain situation. So always the uncertainty is there this particular year especially. So you need to be very careful with so many other things. So yeah, just take care. Any other things? Yeah. So we'll wind up the session now. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So let's close it, because they may have other sessions as well. Okay.
Thank you. Take care.
Right, guys.
Bye.
Thank you.